top of the evening. I'm here. Welcome to a celebration of my personal book of Genesis. It's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night, I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find the things that you do will make me feel alright. You know I work all day to get your money to buy your things, and it's worth it just to hear you say you're gonna give me everything. So why on earth should I moan? 'Cause when I get you alone, you know I feel okay. When I'm home, everything seems to be right. When I'm home, feeling you holding me tight, tight. Yeah, it's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night, I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find the things that you do will make me feel alright. Get you alone, you know I feel okay. When I'm home, everything seems to be right. When I'm home, feeling you holding me tight, tight. Yeah, it's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night, I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find the things that you do will make me feel alright. You know I feel alright. You know I feel alright. A little bit of discord because of a blown chord. But with early Beatles, it's the attitude more than the aptitude. Although, this shit's hard. Surprisingly hard to make simple sounds. Sounds like they fell out of heaven, reconstructed as if they were made by mortal man or woman, in this case, man. One's for Dr. Visco, I believe.
Ooh, I need your love, babe. Guess you know it's true. Hope you need my love, babe, just like I need you. Hold me, love me, hold me, love me. I ain't got nothing but love, babe. 8 days is a week. Love you every day, girl, always on my mind. One thing I can say, girl, love you all the time. Hold me, love me, hold me, love me. I ain't got nothing but love, babe. 8 days a week, 8 days a week. I love you. 8 days a week is not enough to show I care. Ooh, I need your love, babe. Guess you know it's true. Hope you need my love, babe, just like I need you. Oh, oh. Nothing but love, babe. 8 days.
Ah. Like returning to home base, is that? So I got a story for you, true story about 8 days a week. The first record album purchased for me ever was Beatles 6. Now this was the American version of Beatles 6. It had I Don't Want to Spoil the Party. It had shit I don't even remember, because in the digital age, you know, we all feasted on the mono British versions, which were superior, generally speaking, on the early albums. But what's my point? Oh yeah. So Pa got me Beatles 6. He got it for me at Woolworth's on Fifth Avenue in New York City, and right next door was this place that people of a certain age will remember called The Automat. And it was the coolest thing to a 10-year-old kid and his brother. They had sandwiches behind little glass dispensers. You pop in a quarter, twist it, open it, and pull your sandwich out, and then magically it gets refilled with another sandwich. Now, in a world before DoorDash and Uber Eats and anything automated, the Automat was the shit. And that was a memorable day to me because he had just told me he would take me to see, Beatlemania wasn't out yet. This was 78, I think Beatlemania was out in 80. And so it is starting to blend together, but I do know that Pa took me to the Automat. He got me Beatles 6. I played it and played it and played it. And this afternoon, I descended into my meticulously organized garage. That's a joke for people who know me. Looking for it, all I could find was Rubber Soul, which had been purchased for me around the same time. And on the back, we have the track listing along with numbers. The numbers correspond to the counter on my Sound Design stereo, my $50 stereo that I had for years. So if I'd want to fast forward to a particular song, you know, if I'd heard enough of Norwegian Wood and wanted to get to You Won't See Me, well then I would hit fast forward and go to counter number 88. You see, kids, back before instant gratification. Anyway, the point I was trying to make before I sidelined myself was 8 days a week had a real impact on me. I think it was on that album. And so my grandfather, months later, was going on a business trip, and he was going to London, and he said, I will call you Sunday night. To which I said, okay, but who's Sunday night? And he said, valid point, it will be your Sunday night. To which I continued, okay, so what day will it be for you? And he said, well, I think it'll be Monday morning for me. Okay, but what comes after that, and what's the eighth day? And he said, what the hell are you talking about? I said, you know, 8 days a week. That's the first time he called me a schmuck. Schmuck, it's a metaphor. You're talking about the Beatles song, aren't you? It means he loves her so much that there's not enough time, not enough days in the week to tell her. But England has 7 day weeks as well. And that was my first lesson in metaphor from Leon M. Labes, the Beatles enthusiast. So now for a request from one of my oldest and dearest friends, who also gave me grades slightly higher than I deserved in ninth grade in English, because she didn't want to jeopardize my chances of getting into a good college. I thank you, Sue Whalen. You have all my love. Close your eyes. No, damn it, that was gonna be so smooth. But I picked the wrong note. Take two. Can we roll it again? Take two. That was so smooth. Why am I starting on this chord if I'm going to an E minor? Close your eyes and I'll kiss you. Tomorrow I'll miss you. Remember I'll always be true. And then while I'm away, I'll ride home every day. And I'll send all my loving to you. I'll pretend that I'm kissing the lips I am missing and hope that my dreams will come true. And then while I'm away, I'll ride home every day and I'll send all my loving to you. All my loving I will send to you. All my loving, darling, I'll be true. Close your eyes and I'll kiss you. Tomorrow I'll miss you. Remember I'll always be true. Pretend that I'm kissing the lips I am missing and hope all my dreams will come true. And then while I'm away, I'll ride home every day and I'll send all my loving to you. All my loving I will send to you. All my loving, darling, I'll be true. All my loving, oh, all my loving, ooh, all my loving, I will send to you. I swear I nailed it in rehearsal. Seriously, Mr. Epstein, we can practice it again before Top of the Pops. I mean, the Ed Sullivan Show or whatever, 1960 bloody four. So really what gets me about this and musician friends, you may be able to explain this better, or a musicologist might be able to, but you know, I just started going through the early albums yesterday morning, deciding what do I want to play? And they look so simple on paper, and they are simple. Like any half decent guitarist can get these chords down, and the melodies even, and harmonies even, make logical sense, at least in the logic that we've been reared in as musicians. But for some reason, it's really hard to deliver these simple songs. Maybe because there's so much space in them for shit to go wrong, but I think this one was requested by Jill Siegel. I think I'm gonna be sad. I think it's today, yeah. The girl that's driving me mad is going away. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride, but she don't care. She said that living with me was bringing her down, yeah. That she would never be free when I was around. Oh, she's got a ticket to ride.
got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride, but she don't care. I don't know why she's riding so high. She don't think twice, ought to do right by me. Before she sets to saying goodbye, she don't think twice, she ought to do right by me. She said that living with me was bringing her down, yeah. That she would never be free when I was around. Oh, she's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride, but she don't care. My baby don't care. My baby don't care. Don't care. My baby don't care.
So any singer knows that space between the top of your range and the bottom of where you can pull off falsetto, that is the Bermuda frickin' triangle. And Lord knows the Beatles take me there. But I just love this. Thank you for watching. It's like sitting in the most comfortable. I can't hear you, Jeff Rosenberg. You're only in Portland, Oregon. You know, Portland, Oregon. You know, this one's for those in Portland, Oregon. The ones in the front row can just rattle your jewelry. All right, time for credit to the Quiet Beatle, who pulled out a few gems in the early years. This one, in my humble opinion, it's not on the level of innovation, but in the level of sentiment and in the level of sentiment and big-heartedness in the romance department that was odd for its time, I place this one next to God Only Knows by the Beach Boys. Not in overall greatness, but in sweetness. Without being maudlin or saccharine. If I needed someone to love, you're the one that I'd be thinking of. If I needed someone, if I had some more time to spend, then I guess I'd be with you, my friend. If I needed someone, had you come another day, it might not have been like this. But you see, now I'm too much in love. Carve your number on my wall, maybe you will get a call from me. If I needed someone, had you come another day, then it might not have been like this. But you see, now I'm too much in love. Blackbird one of the most beautiful Beatles songs ever. I have limited myself today, however, to the early period. I hereby commit to learning Blackbird for the next time I do Beatles, when I do late stage Beatles. In case you haven't noticed, my guitar playing is pedestrian at best, so I need to steer away from songs that require virtuosity to be effective. Blackbird may be one of them. So I should keep my trap shut till I try it, but I will try it. You have my commitment. So that's Beetle George. And now, for a decidedly more jagged, occasionally nasty Beetle, the one who said we're getting bigger than Jesus Christ caused quite a stir. The man who would sing, "I didn't mean to hurt you, I'm just a jealous guy," spent a lot of years being a jealous guy, and he meant to hurt her, at least during this record. How annoying am I? Very annoying. It occurs to me, in the middle of the night, in the middle of the night, I call your name. Was not planned, but the chords are the same. Next time, when I do solo Beatles. Anybody see the Royal Tenenbaums? They use really, really effective, surprising use of that amazing, weird song, O Yoko by John. Anyway, many years earlier, probably sang this to Cynthia. Well, I'd rather see you dead, little girl, than to be with another man. You better keep your head, little girl, or I won't know where I am. You better run for your life if you can, little girl. Hide your head in the sand, little girl. Got you with another man, that's the end of the little girl. Well, you know that I'm a wicked guy, and I was born with a jealous mind. And I can't spend my whole life trying just to make you toe the line. You better run for your life if you can, little girl. Hide your head in the sand, little girl. Catch you with another man, that's the end, the little girl. Sermon, I mean everything I said. Baby, I'm determined, and I'd rather see you dead. You better run for your life if you can, little girl. Hide your head in the sand, little girl. Catch you with another man, that's the end, little girl. Na 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 na. Should I try a mashup? In the middle of, in the middle of, no. It would be nice if I could do that. It would be a nice tribute to the two sides of John, the matured John. Let's see if I can do it. In the middle of the night, in the middle of the night, I call your name. Oh, yeah. chord missing there. Anybody know it?
In the middle of a dream. In the middle of a dream, I call your name.
Another chord in there that really opens up this song. I'll learn it for next time.
My love will turn you on.
From Imagine, my favorite of all the Beatles solo albums by a long shot. Sorry, Paul. Paul doesn't really need my vote. He's kind of doing okay. Enough of that. It did just occur to me, like, you know, there are only so many chords to draw upon. I could do this for hours. Thank you, Lori. Hi, Lori's daughter. What's her name? Should I say hello? Tell me her name if you want me to say hello to her. I don't know who sang this one. Who sang I Don't Want to Spoil the Party? Wanna spot John. So I will disappear. If she turns up while I'm gone, please let me know. I've had a drink or two and I don't care. There's no fun in what I do if she's not there. I wonder what went wrong. I waited far too long. I think I'll take a walk and look for her. Though tonight she's made me sad, I still love her. If I find her, I'll be glad. I still love her. I've had a drink or two and I don't care. There's no fun in what I do if she's not there. I wonder what went wrong. Waited far too long. I think I'll take a walk and look for her. Though tonight she's made me sad, I still love her. If I find her, I'll be glad. Still love her. I don't want to spoil the party, so I'll go. I would hate my disappointment to show. There's nothing for me here, so I will disappear. If she turns up while I'm gone, please let me know. I've had a drink or two and I don't care. There's no fun in what I do when she's not there. I wonder what went wrong. I waited far too long. I think I'll take a walk and look for her. Why don't I do that more? Just perfection. Like trying to learn a Beatles song, it's being told that something that fell out of the heavens can be decoded and reproduced. It's a ridiculous concept. But it is so among us and so of us. Dude, know, it's like within you and without you. Okay, I'm gonna wing it. So I really wanted to represent Ringo tonight, but from 1962 to 1966, he had a grand total, correct me if I'm wrong, Jeff Rosenberg will correct me if I'm wrong, he had a grand total of one song to his credit, authorship credit, and that was Yellow Submarine, and I don't want to sing Yellow Submarine, I'm sorry. I sang it with my kids when they were babies, it was my hook to try to get them away from Demi Lovato. It worked for maybe an hour, and then it was back to the Disney Channel, but I tried. But I'm sorry, Ringo. You had a lot during the latter period. You were a late bloomer, and then of course, and then Photograph, which is a beautiful, sweet song, which I believe John wrote for you. But still, it's a post-Beatles song that Ringo sang, so you get props for that, and of course, no, 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 I don't smoke anymore. I'm tired of waking up on the floor. No thank you, please, it only makes me sneeze. And then it makes it hard to find the door. Peace and love, peace and love. Okay. This one I've been playing for years and years and years since I saw my hero Elvis Costello do it alone and mashed up with his song Hoover Factory, the oddest of combinations, worked brilliantly. Here I stand, head in hand, turn my face to the wall. She's gone, I can't go on, feeling 2 foot small. Everywhere people stare, each and every day. I can see them laugh at me, and I hear them say, for me. Whether you choose to watch is totally up to you. I do thank you for being here while I visit. It's like recharging the batteries. I don't know why I didn't think of doing this earlier. Ringo and his all-star band, I have heard they put on an amazing show. I know he has Joe Walsh who's telling me this. Hey, Carol. Yeah, I know he had Joe Walsh. I think he bring Brian Wilson along. I know that he had an incredible cast, and Beatles snob that I was, I thought it would be like, you know, too much of a schmaltzy Hollywood review, but that's just stupid and naive. I should have gone, Ringo, I'm sorry. Something tells me there was not an empty seat, but I will fill one when you're back on the road with the All-Star Band. In fact, I would fill that seat to see most anything, live music. I'll be playing live music on Sunday, April 25th. I will be returning to the Crossroads because I will be fully vaccinated. Oh, I didn't know there even was one. Thanks, Eden. I will go. I'll be playing on Sunday, April 25th at the Crossroads. There are exciting talks about a band that may be following me. I may be an opening act for some exciting young talent. And on June 11th, we are booked to play back at the Americana in East Windsor, a fantastic restaurant with a great sound system and a very supportive, wonderful staff. I got to play there on St. Patrick's Day. I was giving thanks on St. Patrick's Day that I got to play there. The audience was a bit skeptical. I told them I was at least as Irish as Elizabeth Warren is Native American. The joke did not go over well. It is a world in which people get easily offended, but I stand by the analogy because it's true. And how about some more Paul? This so dexterously. See, I tuned down. Happy birthday, Warren, on June 11th. We will dedicate the evening to Warren Whalen, my bouncer and provider of generators to unattended music festivals. Always a good friend and a great support. The face, I can't forget the time or place where we just met. She's just the girl for me. I want all the world to see we met. Ha la 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 la. Had it been another day, I might have looked the other way and I'd have never been aware. As it is, I'll dream of her tonight. Ha la 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 la. Falling, yes, I am falling. Then she keeps calling me back again. I have never known the like of this. I've been alone and I have missed things and kept out of sight. Other girls were never quite like this. I lie, lie, la da da. Falling, yes I am falling. And she keeps calling me back again. Again. You know who did that great? The late, great Pat DiNizio of the Smithereens. That was a staple of his, and he did a wonderful job with it. All right, so I'm going to close the evening. Boy, has this been fun. We're going to do more Beatles nights. So this particular song in the history of the Beatles, in my particular path with the Beatles as a songwriter, where I went from fan to someone in whom a seed was planted to maybe write songs of his own, I think it's hard. it would be weird to be inspired solely by the Beatles, because like, that's like listening to Hamilton and saying, oh yeah, I want to write songs like Lin-Manuel Miranda. Like, who doesn't? But that's like godlike skill. So the Beatles didn't really drive me to want to write songs, because they were just too great and accomplished. But at a certain point, and it was around 1966 when they did Rubber Soul, and right after Rubber Soul, Revolver, that's when everything expanded. And the four of them started going in different directions. Really incredible, weird, amazing directions. I mean, look at what they did in like 8 years. They only existed as a band for something like 8 years. That's ridiculous what they've done, what they did. I mean, we know that. But anyway, so the path that John started taking, this song has always been like a breaking off point. In it, I hear the seeds of what would drive me to write music, and that is the angry young man, bullshit calling of my hero Elvis Costello, and the snarl of my hero Bob Dylan, baked into a pop metaphor. And it's no accident, I think, that of the songs that I tried playing a harmonica to, this is the only one that it seemed to work with, where it didn't sound out of place. Tell me that you got everything you want, and your bird can sing, but you don't get me. And your bird is green, but you can't see me. You can't see me. When your prized possessions start to weigh you down, look in my direction, I'll be round, I'll be round. Bird can't swing, but you can't hear me. But you can't hear me. When your prized possessions start to weigh you down, look in my direction, I'll be round, I'll be round. Tell me that you've got everything you want, and your bird can't sing, but you don't get me. You don't get me. You'll say you've seen seven wonders, and your bird is green, but you can't see. Thanks for joining. See you guys next week. Have a great week.